On March 26th, a Boeing 787 departed Seoul Airport operating flight XAA4787. The aircraft, operated by Comlux, spent the next 20 hours in the air before landing in Buenos Aires, Argentina. Ultra-long-haul flights are still a contentious issue. Any flight over 12 hours comes with questions about pilot concentration and passenger health issues. But that hasn't stopped some commercial and private airlines from pushing the limits of their jets. Even 12 hours in the air may seem like a long time, but one Comlux aircraft spent a massive 20 hours and 19 minutes flying at the end of March. The Boeing 787, registration Papa 4787, departed Seoul and South Korea and flew non-stop across the Pacific Ocean until it reached Buenos Aires, Argentina. The flight had a great circle distance of 19,487 kilometers. Comlux's CEO Andrea Zanetto confirmed that the flight was for private clients and wasn't just a test. On board were six pilots on rotation, with one engineer to keep an eye on the plane. Zanetto also said that Comlux was thrilled to undertake the challenge of offering luxury over such a great distance. He went on to point out that connecting Seoul and Buenos Aires is perhaps the longest route an aircraft can take. Comlux is a luxury private charter airline that offers a range of aircraft, including Boeing 767, 777, and 787. Comlux facilitates private air travel for large groups of people, including sports teams, royal families, businesses, and governments. While private jets usually cater to only a few passengers at a time, it's possible that the Dreamliner was carrying an entire team of people halfway around the world. Carrying a large group that far requires precise calculations regarding weight and fuel consumption, but it is possible. On a Project Sunrise test, Qantas used a Boeing Dreamliner with 49 passengers to fly for 19 hours and 16 minutes. Air Tahiti Nui also used a Dreamliner to fly for just under 16 hours. With technology making ultra-long-haul flights possible, we might just see more of them taking place. Recent travel restrictions have added new complications to layovers, as they may require crew and passengers to quarantine or not leave the aircraft at all. Once restrictions are lifted, ultra-long-haul may well become fairly standard. Vistara is reportedly in talks with Boeing to add additional crew rest areas to several Dreamliners to allow the crew to take breaks or even operate in shifts on long flights. Researchers have also been testing various in-seat physical activities to help passengers cope with the strain of ultra-long haul. In addition, new aircraft have features such as customizable LED lighting to help minimize jet lag and minimize mental fatigue. Busy routes between major cities such as New York, London, and Sydney may well see regular ultra-long-haul flights over the coming few years. Airlines appear to be looking into the idea very seriously. The only question is, how many people would be willing to spend that long in the air? What do you think? Would you be willing to spend 20 hours in the air if it meant avoiding a stopover? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles and a podcast every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe before you go.